Hey guys, it's Chunky Aviation here, and today I'm going to be making a tutorial for you guys. Now, a lot of you have requested tutorials, and most of you were expecting tutorials, because I said I would make them, like General Potato Head, where he'd show you how to build an aircraft, like each individual model of aircraft, just like how he would. Now, I'm showing you a method of building aircraft that I use. So it's going to be kind of like ZBLDS's, except that I'm only really going to be showing you guys how to trace stuff in Photoshop, because his is a little outdated, and I kind of do it slightly differently. So I will just be showing you guys that. I'm sorry for those of you who wanted to see a tutorial of me actually like putting this stuff together in Minecraft, but that's kind of like a trade secret for me. Like, that method I kind of want to keep to myself, because, I mean, that's like how I define myself and distinguish myself on YouTube, and I don't really want to give that up. Also, yes, for those of you who are like, what is happening on my desktop, that is from Shakira's Empire. If you don't know or don't like Shakira, what are you doing with your life?
Follow you down wherever you go. I am, baby, I'm bound to you, and do you know? Take off all of your skin and brave when you are free.
6.5 hours later.
So we're back. Of course, you guys needed a Shakira break because Shakira is everything.
Truth or dare on the dance floor.
You guys are just like, seriously. Okay, so we're good. Some good. These are not very accurate, but I'm gonna try to show you guys how to trace the 747-100 because it's not a very popular plane. So not many of you will actually use this. If you do, please make sure to credit me. I don't think there's going to be any good ones on Google Images. Yeah, they're all pretty low res. I wouldn't use this. It's really low res. So, okay. On Wikipedia, they often have line drawings like this. So, I don't usually ever use these because they're not exactly very accurate. They're just guesstimates. Google Images often has good ones, but not for every plane. Like, A340s do not, or 717s and MD-80s don't have any good blueprints. So then I just use line drawings because they look just like the planes do in real life, and they do when you trace them too. So, yes, there's no blueprint of this anywhere. So if I do make this, which I will because this plane is really cool, I will have to make it from this blueprint. And anyway, this tutorial is not about exactly building a plane, so I'll just use this blueprint to show you guys how to make the Dash 100. The SP is really small. I did find a good blueprint for it, though, so. Yeah, you can see the door starts over the wing. Yeah. Okay. So, please have Photoshop installed. There's Shakira, of course. Before doing this, because a good alternative for Photoshop is GIMP, G-I-M-P. They're pretty good, but Photoshop's still a lot better. So this is CC, not CS6. For the few of you who care, I'm going to put a white layer behind this because Boeing. Yes, this is my to-do list. It's Momentum is what this app is. It's pretty cool. Boeing 747-100 length. So this is what's going to help us scale it in Photoshop. Okay, so new layer. And I'm going to change the canvas size because when we put in the grid, it might not come out right. So I'm going to change this to pixels. 82. Okay, 2,500. Or just 7 inches. Okay, I'm keep on changing. I need to make up my mind. Okay, I'm just going to go with 9. There we go. And fill it with white. So, okay. I'm going to go to view, show, grid. So, yes. And that's not going to be accurate for dash 100. That's just from my last plane. Snap to grid. Yeah, okay. So, people doubt Wikipedia usually, but actually they have pretty accurate plane information. Okay, seriously. One thing about Wikipedia is that when you go into side window mode, it's at a different scroll place than when it's, like, the entire size of the screen. Okay, so these are all the same length, and the dash 8's longer, so 70.6 meters, right? So 70.6 times 2. Wow. Okay. This is not hard. I'm just making it so that you guys can see. 141.2. So basically, I'm going to try to make each grid line every 10 pixels. So it's going to be 1,412. Probably. Let's see if that works. It might not, though. That might be too big. It doesn't go over 1,000. I forgot. Yeah. So 141.2 resolution. Okay, here we go. 141.2. Yeah, see, it just goes to 1,000. So then, sorry. Okay. Times 8. 7. Okay, let's do some 7. 988.4. So that's going to be the width of a dash 100. So what our goal is now is to scale the dash 100 into these grid lines. Ugh. Okay. So let's go to transform. No, that's too small. Was it already correct? Oh, it needs to be bigger. Huh. I was looking at the wrong lines as the grid lines. So this needs to be here. And that's okay. 125. That's. What am I doing? This is a failure. Okay. Always takes a while though. So 115. Nope. 110. It's pretty close. Let me see if it's actually accurate, though. It's a little over. It's a little... Yeah, that'll work. That'll work fine. And that's pretty accurate. So it's every 7 pixels is going to be each block. So that's how you get it. Pretty accurate. And with, like, an actual accurate blueprint, then your plane is pretty much 100% accurate. But on, like, a plane like... Seriously. On a plane like this, it's kind of a problem because there aren't really any good blueprints for it. I was surprised that SP had good blueprints, but it did, so. And Wikipedia will sometimes miss things. There are 3 upper deck windows, so I'm just going to add a 3rd one there. Just guesstimate. And that door is on the other side of the aircraft, I think. I'm not completely sure. Yes, my name is Beyonce, according to Momentum. Okay. Yeah, it's on the other side of the aircraft. So, now we're going to start dividing this into multiple layers first. With GIMP, I don't even think you can really do that. It's kind of weird. So, we're going to get rid of all the other aircraft on here. Although I will, like, because this is just for the dash 100. I can't even see which aircraft is which. Okay. Let's get rid of these, and my Photoshop skills are looking horrible right now. Okay, so let's go to SP. Such a cute aircraft. It's ridiculously small considering it's a double decker. And then let's call this layer white. This layer is going to be side view. and cover everything on here, subtract this. And then let's, on side view, we're just gonna delete that. And I'm just gonna make this more opaque because it's lines and that does not often work very well with Photoshop. So this is gonna be top view. And then the next one's gonna be cross section. So here we go. Cross section. And there we go. Now we're just gonna make block layers. And the reason why I split them up is because the blueprint is not going to be lined perfectly to the blocks like we're going to need it on here, if that makes any sense. You'll see what I mean in a second. Because we need to align each layer individually so that the blocks will work. So let's start tracing this. Okay. And I'm trying to think of how I do my 747s. How would this go? Is this, wait, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. See, because this is not an accurate blueprint, it's not exactly lined up correctly. So I'm trying to make this work for my purposes, but this may not be completely right, because time to pull up a render of my 747. So this video is going to be pretty long. You guys are watching it, so you would know, but like, it's already been 11 minutes. 1, 1, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1. Okay. Wait, so this would be 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1. Okay, so I'm just going to line it up like this so that it'll work for my purposes. This is going to be, I think I do three blocks. Yes, I do three blocks. That's going to be black. Okay, wait. I'm going to do black 50% so that you can see the lines under it. And I'm just going to go like that. So now we're going to shape out the nose. Now I'm going to make it not like my nose, just so that you guys can, you can't really like copy what I would normally do. So I'm changing it up a little bit here, because normally I wouldn't shape it like that. Okay, that's not how I would form a nose at all. Okay, so I'm just going to change it and do it how I would normally do it, because it's just bugging me. So, and you, so you guys can actually see how I would do it. Okay. So this would be here. This block here. 2, 3, 1. And this. Yeah, that's how I would do it. And I would move the, that's how I moved the plane on my original blueprint. So 1, 2, 1, 2. I think I did 3, yeah. 4. So what I like to do is every time this line reaches half a block, I go to the next one so that I can balance the fact that this is jutting out with the fact that this is jutting inwards for each block in Minecraft, if that makes any sense. I think I did 4, just to make it look like a nice curve. And then that, and then that. That's pretty much what I did, I think. And then this would be the cockpit windows, which are like that. This blueprint is not exactly accurate, so I'm like, I should be doing, just tracing it so you guys can see, but I just kind of want to make it correct for you guys. Just so you, if you guys ever use this blueprint, can't even see, yeah, that's 3 blocks, so this, there should be an extra block right here, but whatever. Let's try to pure blue. How would, okay, RG would be 0. And then, yeah. So I'd start by doing the basic general, like, aircraft shape. The tail on 747, I'm going to do that next because it's pretty cool. So here, I would never want one block jutting out of the top back. So I'm going to just, even though they connect right here, I'm going to make two there, then two here, and gradually make it steeper so that it gets correct down here. So 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2. I wouldn't do a 1 though. So as you can see, this process is just really annoying. So I think I'd go 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2. Yes, okay. So that's kind of lying, but whatever. 2. It's way steeper than the actual tail. Slightly steeper than the actual tail. But it's just that it'll look good. And you can see that that's not correct. So what I might actually do is I might make it even on... Just make it push it further back, like how it... If that makes... That did not make any sense. By that I mean just keep it at 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. So that it ends up further to the right than where it would be. But it looks better than how it did earlier when it was steeper, and it's more accurate, so I'm going to stick with that. The front of the 747 tail is not a 45 degree angle like most tails, it's flatter. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. This is not accurate, like this blueprint itself. It's just annoying me because I know this isn't right. Whatever. 2, 3, 4. I'll go back and fix it in a second, which is pretty cool and nice about Photoshop. These line drawings. Okay, and it's not even... I'm kind of happy that it's not accurate, though, so that you guys can... Like... not really copy the accurate one that I use. So also, as you guys know, I am horrible at commentary during winter break or any break of any sort ever. So I know I sound horrible as always. Sorry, people. And here we go. By the way, my parts are all arriving tomorrow except for my GPU, which is so annoying because that's the one part I need to, like, make it all right. Oh, make sure to save your work as you go, unlike me. Okay. 1, 2, 1, 2. So what I would actually normally do here, first of all, I usually go 3, 4, 4, and then even it out down here, but this blueprint's not letting me do that, so... Normally, this would actually be 2. Okay, let me just try work around this problem. This needs to be gone. So, I think I'm going to go like that and then move some other stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. That'll work. And it's better than it was before. Okay. And then, of course, the fuselage would be here. I'm just going to leave it like that. And then we're going to trace out this bump here. People think, like, Jordan Code TV, John World Data Head, sometimes mess this up. It's not actually 4, it's not 3, it's not 6. Some people do that. It's 2 blocks above. Even the line drawing has that right. So, Wikipedia, kudos to you. Now the thing is, if I were doing it how I would normally do it, I'd go here and then start going up. The problem with that means that the hump is starting too far forward. So I always have to think these things through. So I'm going to maybe have it come up right on the block where the pixels start showing up. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So make it 1, 2, 3. See, now this, I always use quartz stairs for that, right? And I don't want that on the last block. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have this, and then have this come out over here. And there we go. I'll put that on this block later. So there we go. We trace that out. And then the landing gear is going to be 4 blocks off the ground. Say this is the ground. And yeah. So engines on a -100 are very weird, as you know. As most of you know, probably. Okay. And then let's trace out the rear. Here it's not actually flat. It actually curves, like, it's kind of concave, which is, most people don't know, but it slightly is. You'll see that when you start tracing blocks. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna go 4, 5, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, forgot, I can fix that, yeah. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, on the line drawing, apparently it's not concave. But normally it slightly is. 5, 6, 7, 8. 7. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. Make it so that the curve is more gentle. It's going to be go 5, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 5, 5, 7. And then that'll go there. So we've basically traced out the fuselage.
Stuck in the socket, it's just a nature, a game. Get ready, we'll do it again. Let's not recover from the hangover. When your eyes got me drunk, I was sober.
Is it true that you love me? I dare you to kiss me. With everyone watching, it's truth or dare on the dance floor.